Makes a Marriage Successful. In his 1995 book called The Five Love Languages, Gary Chapman states, "We train ourselves to analyze problems and create solutions. We forget that marriage is a relationship, not a project to be completed or a problem to solve." My name is Lachelle Downing, and today I'm going to tell you three ways a marriage can be successful. The first way is commitment. Commitment is huge in a marriage, and one of the things that I believe a marriage is a covenant between two people. And Webster defines a covenant as a formal or serious agreement or promise. And for me, those are pretty deep words. So the first thing being commitment, you have to be willing to commit to not just your spouse, but being committed to everything that goes along with marriage and committing to your marriage vows and those things that you promise to each other and understanding that it's a binding agreement between the two of you. And putting your spouse as a priority in your life, before your friends, before your community, making sure that you are 100% committed to what makes your marriage work and what it is that your spouse needs and wants from you. And to not forget that covenant. And if you don't forget that covenant, then you will be able to stay committed if you just are constantly reminding yourself that this isn't just a relationship that we are in. This is a covenant we have made together, an agreement, a commitment to stay together, which is so unheard of anymore. A lot of people are just so willing to walk away from that. So first is commitment, and the second thing is knowledge. I believe that it's very important in making a marriage successful that you get to know your spouse, not just the things that made you fall in love with them, but the things that are going to make your marriage work after all of the puppy love stage is over and after you have, you've gotten married, and then it's getting to know their likes and their dislikes. What are their love languages? Do they work best off of words of affirmation? Do they work best off of gifts? For me personally, it's words of affirmation, being told that I'm doing a good job at something, being told that I look pretty. But maybe for my husband, it's just deeds being done, like things being done around the house. That is, for him, that's what tells him I love him. So getting to know your spouse, what are their likes, what are their dislikes from here to eternity? And understanding that your reaction to something may or may not cause them to react a certain way. And just really understanding and knowing your spouse inside and out. So those, in words of affirmation and deeds and all those things, by getting to know your spouse, I feel like we're communicating that way. We're communicating love to our spouse. So the third thing and the final thing is communication. And for me, growing up, my mom always said that communication is the first thing to cause a problem in a relationship. A lot of people had said money, and yes, money does cause huge problems in marriages. But for us, it was communication. It was how do you communicate. Growing up, for me, my mom and dad never raised their voice at each other. They communicated daily everything that they needed and wanted from each other. And in his same book, Gary Chapman states, "Recent research has indicated that the average individual listens for 17 seconds before interrupting and interjecting their own ideas." And I know that that's very true because automatically we get defensive when we hear someone saying something. We get defensive and we have to interrupt them and make our point. And so many times in marriages we don't listen and we don't hear what our spouse is actually trying to say. Sometimes there's just an underlying thing that they're trying to say, or maybe even a hidden message, but because we're so quick to be defensive, we aren't listening to what they're trying to communicate to us. So don't be so quick to have such a response and to get defensive. Be patient, listen, hear what your spouse is saying, so that you can understand the full message that they're trying to convey. And be slow to speak. That's something that I've had to learn even in my own marriage. Just wait. Maybe it's not the right time to have that response. And also part of communication is something that my husband and I do daily, is setting aside time where we can communicate about our day. How was your day? How was your day? This is what's going on the rest of the week. This is what's going on with the kids. But in addition to that, communicating concerns that you have in your marriage, concerns that you just have personally, things that are bothering you, because we don't want to keep secrets from our spouses. We want to have that open communication, that open relationship with them, so that we have an understanding of where they're coming from, they have an understanding where we're coming from, And if we don't communicate all of those things with each other effectively, then things get held inside, secrets get kept, and communication will eventually lead to a destruction of marriage. Build each other up, encourage each other. That is another way of communicating, just saying, hey, I hope you have a good day. That's communication. Also, words of affirmation, just ways of showing your spouse that you love them, and definitely keeping no secrets. So in closing, I just wanted to share, if couples will stay committed to each other and their vows and invest in learning about each other and learn how to communicate effectively, their marriage can and will be successful. And I'd like to leave you with a few words from an American pastor. His name was Harry Emerson Fosdick. He says, it is not marriage that fails, it is people who fail. All that marriage does is show them up. Invest in the lifelong commitment you have made to each other. I promise it will be worth it in the end. Thank you very much for coming.